Heaven Official's Blessing, Chapter 104, Audio Source, WuxiaWorldAudiobook.com. Venerable of Empty Words, Morning at the Feast. It was also many years ago when Xie Lian met a Venerable of Empty Words. That time, he had just finished constructing a small hut by his own power, and was just standing there admiring his new abode when suddenly, a tiny little voice came from one of the corners. "This dwelling of yours will collapse in 2 months. So what did you do?" Xi Qingxian asked. "Nothing," Xie Lian replied. "I said, 2 months. If it's still standing in 7 days, then it'd be a real miracle." Single quote, quote, dot. Hua Cheng's lips curved slightly, but immediately that smile faded away. That venerable of empty words hid in the shadows, waiting to suck Xie Lian's fear, frustration, insecurity, and other such negative emotions. However, it sucked nothing but empty air, and even when Xie Lian had finished brushing up and fell asleep in his new house, it still hadn't sucked anything. Although Xie Lian never saw its form, he could still sense that it was probably quite angry. Not a few days later, a lightning struck down, and the entire hut was scorched. That venerable of empty words was pleased, probably thinking that scorched was no different than collapsed, so its curse was technically fulfilled, and Xie Lian must be afraid now. Yet that didn't happen. It still didn't manage to suck anything that could fill its stomach. Of course it was malcontent, thus it followed after Xie Lian and waited for the next joyous occasion. Who knew that this wait turned into over half a year? In that half a year, Xie Lian had not one joyous occasion. If this was anyone else, they would have given up. However, the venerable of empty words had a unique trait, and that was obstinance. If they should die a prey, they would be relentless in their pursuit, and so it starved pathetically for half a year. Finally, an opportunity had risen. One day, Xie Lian managed to collect a large bundle of junk and made a small fortune. The venerable of empty words was overjoyed. Having waited this long, it immediately used all the tricks it had, and stream after streams of curses erupted. Such is the exciting life of after Xie Lian struck it rich, he would waste his fortune on drinks and gambling, then fall sick with long strings of debt, etc. Xie Lian counted his money and listened with indulgent amusement. After, he still only brushed up and went to bed, and that venerable of empty words still sucked nothing. That night, Xie Lian's pile of junk caught on fire. After the fire was put out, ashen-faced, Xie Lian sighed and said to the venerable of empty words, "What a shame. It's all burnt. Not a single scrap left. I haven't even experienced any of those drunken dreams and lifetime of riches you spoke of. I think the things you say are quite interesting, so how about you tell me some more?" This happened several times, and towards the end, Xie Lian would actually ask it before it even spoke, "Do you have anything to say? Do you want to say something?" Until that venerable of empty words couldn't take it anymore and fled. To venerables of empty words, a god of misfortune like Xie Lian was extremely unfavorable. Either he'd have no happy occasions and it'd wait for nothing, or he'd already gotten used to all the bad luck and suffered no fear or anxiety. His luck was so bad to the point it was outside the imagination of that venerable of empty words, so Xie Lian felt nothing of their curses and even treated them like well wishes or daydreams. In any case, after that, Xie Lian never ran into any venerable of empty words again. He'd even suspect that maybe after having fled, that venerable of empty words went back to its people and rudely publicized how awful he was. Listening up to this point, Xi Qingxian didn't manage to hold it in and puffed a laugh. Hua Cheng said quietly, "Is it very funny?" Xi Qingxian knew it was inappropriate too, and instantly schooled his expression, apologizing with a serious tone. "Sorry, Your Highness." Xie Lian laughed. "Don't worry. I think it's pretty amusing too," he concluded. The venerable of empty words suck power from fear in people's hearts, and from this power, it'd push for its predictions to come true, then make a new prediction. The cycle continues until the person is thoroughly broken and their heart destroyed. So, the more the heart is unsteady, the worse it is. And the more one has, the more one fears loss. After a pause, he suggested, did the Lord Windmaster receive a prayer of this sort from a worshipper and is asking you for help? You're the god of wind, something like this isn't under your jurisdiction. If you received this prayer, you can very well pass it on to a martial god. However, Shi Qingxin said, it's not a worshipper who ran into it, it was me. Now Xie Lian was even more bewildered. You ran into one yourself? The venerable of empty words usually don't dare to mess with heavenly officials. Even if they messed with you, as an esteemed heavenly official, there's nothing to be afraid of. Shi Qingxin sighed. If I had run into it after my ascension, then of course there's nothing to worry over, but it's a long story. This was many hundreds of years ago, when the wind and water masters were still mortals. They were born and raised in an affluent and prosperous merchant household. Shi Qingxin was the second son, and when he was born, the entire family rejoiced. They gave the second son the baby name Wan Zan, and they widely distributed porridge and such fares to feed the hungry in order to build merits through acts of compassion. At the time, there was a fortune teller who ate porridge and saw the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes. He asked for the birth details and said this, since I've eaten porridge from your household, I will say this. This son of yours might have a good life, but it's hard to tell you the whole story. Just know, if you want to save him, he must be kept low profile. Don't raise him to be the boisterous, flaunting kind. Don't give him the chance to shine. Remember to build fortune in muffled quiet, and this will ensure he live a life of peace. Be sure to never host any feasts for him or it will bring something bad. Those were not pleasant words and very much like something a venerable of empty words would say. The Shi family was a merchant household, and all of the qualities he described were especially valuable to them, so the fortune teller was shooed away immediately, and his words were not taken seriously. A few days later, a feast was held in Shi Qingxin's honor. The lanterns shone and the banners flew, drums roared and gongs sounded. However, at the feast, just as the guests were at the height of hollering their congratulations, singing songs of praises to the second young master of the Shi family wrapped in swaddling cloths, a sing-song voice suddenly rang out from the ground, chanting, "Wretched beginning, wretched end." That voice really did come from the floor, but it overtook the voices of everyone present, and all became dumbfounded with shock. The feast ended with apprehension thick in the air. And that very night, Shi Qingxin, who was still a baby, became hot with fever, crying nonstop, and the heat refused to go down no matter what was done, even dry heaving at times. The entire family was terrified. The Shi family remembered that not long ago there was that fortune teller who spoke strange words who was kicked out, so they hastily searched all over and invited him back. That fortune teller said, I told you to keep a low profile but you wouldn't listen. Now that child has caught the eye of the reverend, his entire life will be filled with misfortune. This bout of fever is nothing, it will go away on its own. But this, it's nothing more than a greeting gift. Of course, he was talking about the venerable of empty words. Except, this wasn't a typical venerable of empty words that could be chased away so easily, but one that was extremely old in years, one that was strongest in cultivation. How strong! Even without joyous occasions it could still mourn. Thus, it was called the Reverend of Empty Words. This Reverend was the so-called the shop that can close for 3 years, but eats for 3 years once it opens. Its eyes were sharp and malicious. The prey it clung to were never any less than characters of greatness whose lives were filled with large waves and legends. Some managed to win against it, but still they'd pay their entire lives to battle, providing it with significant portions of food. Some were defeated and thoroughly became a source of its powers. Having hoarded for close to 1,000 years, its foundation was deep and thick. Now, it had rested for over 100 years. Counting the days, it was time to stretch its legs, and when it opens its mouth to feed, for sure it'd be another large bite. Coincidentally, the Shi Qingxian who was just born was exactly to its taste, and was thus reserved by this reverend. Although the tiny baby wouldn't understand its predictions even if he heard, there would be one day he could understand, and one day he would know fear. Besides, once this fear was planted in the boy's childhood, it would be deeply embedded, unable to be dispelled. Fortunately, monsters like these usually only had one nerve in their brains, and the way they thought was strange, quite abnormal. Thus, the fortune teller thought of a way to trick it. Have the Shi family send Shi Qingxian away and pretend he was given to another family, then change the appearance of the son to that of a female baby before bringing him back. Have the family claim that the female babe was a kept daughter and have the whole Shi family call the little young master Little Lady, raise him as a girl. As long as the Reverend of Empty Words could not find the male baby it reserved after time has gone, it surely wouldn't remember who it picked. Thus, sure enough, Shi Qingxian matured to 10 years of age in peace. Within those 10 years, the once wealthy merchant household had gradually declined. The parents of the two masters passed away. Internal conflicts raged in the family, fighting over inheritance. Shi Wudu was tired of it all, so the year he turned 16, he left home bringing with him the little Shi Qingxian who was younger by many years. The brothers depended on each other to live, and Shi Wudu was the first to enter the mountains to cultivate under a master, settling the little brother in a town at the foot of the mountain. Every day he'd cultivate and train until late, not descending the mountains until late into the night. There was nothing to eat in the mountains and he could only eat at home at night. One evening, Shi Wudu lost sense of time sparring with another. Shi Qingxian waited for a long time and still his brother wasn't home. Worried that Shi Wudu would be hungry, he decided to deliver the food up the mountains. Shi Qingxian was still a child at the time and didn't know how to hike the mountain in paths. The night was dark and after having walked a long time with the food box, he suddenly needed to relieve himself. Anxiously, he immediately pulled up his skirt at the side of the road. Just then, a black shadow approached from the far end of the mountain road, asking, "Is it sun or up AED?" Hearing someone call his baby name, Shi Qingxian thought it was his brother who had sent someone to come find him, so he hurriedly dropped his skirt again, acknowledging the call. "It's me," that foreign voice asked again. "Is your birth such year, such month, such day, such time?" Shi Qingxian was puzzled. First, why the sudden ask for his birth information, and second, that person had it all correct. So he acknowledged again. "That's right. How did you know? Who are you? Do you know my brother?" That voice didn't answer, but in the end, it said, "Come over here and let me see your face clearly." That was the tone of a command. At the point, Shi Qingxian finally noticed something amiss. He hugged that food box and dashed away. As he ran, he could hear whirls of mad winds behind, laughing crazily. That thing was chasing him closely. It shouted, "You're going to fall right now." Shi Qingxian was thoroughly horrified, and when it said, "Fall," he tripped and fell, breaking the food box and rice spilled all over the ground. Just as that creature was about to pounce, Shi Wudu arrived. Seeing someone had come, that Reverend of Empty Words disappeared out of sight. Shi Wudu hugged the little brother who was face covered in blood and rice from the fall, both of them shocked and terrified. It still found him. After having hidden for so many years, the Reverend of Empty Words finally had its first taste of sweetness, and from then on, it would appear regularly, each time more mysterious than the last. The cultivation of that creature was too strong. The Shi family fortune was already depleted and the cultivators that Shi Wudu managed to hire could do nothing to it. He hadn't the power to throw out a million merits to have his voice heard directly by the heavens either. Although that creature never asked for Shi Qingxian's life, still the two brothers knew that it was only biding its time, waiting to butcher only when the prey is fattened. Right now it was only slapping your face gently, reminding you to fear it, but there would be one day when the slap would hurt. This was like a hunter who wouldn't kill its prey with just one arrow, and had to brush many against it, thoroughly terrifying the prey, feeding off its terror. This was nothing more than a torturous execution. Fortunately, a turning point had finally come. After many years of aggressive training, Shi Wudu ascended. The moment he ascended, he immediately brought Shi Qingxian to the middle court. Aggressively using up rare treasures and divine riches, and a few years later, Shi Qingxian also successfully ascended. That reverend of empty words thus quieted and disappeared. Shi Qingxian naturally believed that it finally gave up and backed off, knowing its own hardship. Yet, it seemed it was Yi who thought too well of things. A few days ago, he invited a bunch of friends to drink, and as he was inebriated, he suddenly heard a malicious voice in his ear. "You will never be able to see your brother again." That voice was exceedingly familiar. In the days between he was 10 and before his ascension, he could hear that voice at least once or twice every year, his fear for it sunken deeply into his bones, and this was like an explosive had exploded next to his ear. Shi Qingxian sobered up instantly and rushed to Pei Ming's domain in terror, only relaxing when he saw with his own eyes Shi Wudu well and hanging out with Ling Wen and the other. Afterwards, he wondered if that voice was his own delusion. After all, that creature had planted a deep shadow in his heart since he was young, and it wasn't the first time that's happened. However, after some thought, he was still worried, so he dragged Ming Yi over to find Xie Lian to ask for assistance. He hadn't expected to bump into Hua Cheng at Puqi Shrine. Truly the road is narrow for enemies. After hearing the story, Xie Lian commented, "So, the one Lord Windmaster met and the one I met were on completely different levels." After some thought, he turned to Hua Cheng. "San Lelang, have you ever seen that reverend of empty words before?" Hua Cheng was toying with a pair of chopsticks in his hand and replied, "Him, I've never seen with my own eyes. However, I know someone who had." Although Xie Lian was curious who this someone he knows was, he didn't ask after it, and only said, "Just how strong is its cultivation? Is it really that powerful?" Hua Cheng tossed the chopsticks and replied lazily, "Very strong." Hearing this, both Shi Qingxian and Ming Yi's expressions grew solemn. Hua Cheng added, "It's not like your regular little minions. It's definitely hard to deal with." Although he said, "hard to deal with," still his expression remained normal, like he was only saying it out of courtesy. However, to receive such a comment from Hua Cheng, it was definitely something. Xie Lian said, "Lord Windmaster, this problem doesn't seem small. Why not tell Lord Watermaster?" Shi Qingxian waved his hand. "No, no. You have to know, my brother is about to undergo another heavenly calamity. If he should go fight that reverend of empty words during this time, what if he loses focus? I have to keep this a secret, no one must know. I didn't tell a single official who has a good relationship with my brother. A heavenly official didn't just go through a heavenly calamity three once. The more calamities passed, the greater their divine state, the more unshakable their status, and the stronger their spiritual powers. Shi Wudu was a heavenly official who had passed two calamities already. And Xie Lian had also heard in the leisurely chats in the spirit communication array that he was waiting for the third one now. It definitely wouldn't be favorable should he lose focus. To fail to pass a calamity, no matter what, the attained divine state would be dropped. Translator's notes. Baby names are nicknames given before a formal name is decided. The torture described in the original text is Ling Kai. It's a torture technique that appeared in the early 10th century where the executioner would slice the flesh of the condemned with a small knife bit by bit until the person is dead. Gods in Chinese folklores are a lot like Greek gods, wherein each controlled an aspect in the mortal world. To ascend, a mortal must pass through a heavenly calamity, a test of strength to see if the person has what it takes to become divine. Once ascended, a god can go through many more trials to level up, or attain a greater divine state. The trials are non-negotiable and written into the fate of each god, so they come at different times. Each trial is different. Sometimes the god descends to live one lifetime as a mortal, or fight natural disasters, etc. etc. To fail a trial, however, means dropping in the attained divine state and losing powers, so the stakes are high going in and there's no turning back. End chapter.